Most people who regularly go out into the hills will have heard of Naismiths Rule. And if you haven't heard of it, it's a formula that can be used to help plan a walk because it gives you a rough guide for how long it will take to get somewhere. So let's get the basics out of the way first. If you know how far you have to walk and the speed that you travel, then you can work out how long it will take you to get somewhere. Naismiths adds in also the time it will take you to walk up what are described as easy slopes. And if you add these two times together, the distance and the height gain, then you'll know how long it will take you to get somewhere. As Naismith's rule is quite often misquoted, just for the sake of historical accuracy, I'll drop this onto your screen when I get home. This will be a page of the Journal of the Scottish Mountaineering Club from 1892. It's when William Wilson Naismith first published his ideas. Now, you'll notice that he didn't call it a rule, but rather he said it was a simple formula that could be useful in estimating what time men in fair condition should allow for easy expeditions. But don't forget that Naismith was a leading Edwardian mountaineer. So when he says men in fair condition, he was talking about fit and healthy mountaineers, which today most people aren't. His formula was quite simply you take an hour for every 3 miles on the map, with an additional hour for every 2,000 feet of ascent. And this works out, you know, the modern version of this is 5 kilometers, or approximately 3 miles an hour, plus 10 minutes for each 100 meters, or 330 feet of rise. Now, there are a lot of ways to work out how long it will take you to walk somewhere. There's things like, I'm trying to think of something, there's a lot of ways and I'm trying to think of them. So, oh yeah, there's Tobler's hiking function, you know, you can Google that, or there's altimetry calculations. But for most of these, you need a calculator to work things out. And the reason Naismiths is so popular is quite simply that it's so simple. As I said, it's 5 kilometers an hour plus 10 minutes for each 100 meters of rise. So if I want to walk somewhere, which is say, I don't know, 10 kilometers away, it will take me 2 hours to cover that 10 kilometer distance at 5 kilometers an hour. And let's say that along the way, if you add up all the ups and downs, let's say that I'll be rising a total of 500 meters in height. So I need to add 10 minutes for each 100 meter rise. So that's an extra 50 minutes. So Naismith's rule tells me that the total time for the journey will be 2 hours 50 minutes. I mean, how simple is that? Now also, anybody who's doing their mountain leaders training logbook in the UK will have had Naismith's continually drummed into them. So they'll know that it's that 5 kilometers an hour works out at 12 minutes per kilometer. Okay, and we know that we need 10 minutes for each 100 meters of, you know, that you're going to ascend. So let's pick an example. Let's say that we want to walk, I don't know, 4 kilometers, and there's a 300 meter rise. So that's 4 times 12 minutes, which is 48 minutes, you know, for the distance, plus I'll be going up 300 meters. So that's 3 times 10 minutes for the rise. So it'll take me a total of 1 hour, 18 minutes. I'll give you a real world example. At the moment, I'm on Spittler's Edge at spot 392. We'll call it 390, you know, just round it off, make it easy. So I'm on Spittler's Edge at 390, or 392 really. Now, let's say that I want to walk from here to Great Hill. I'll drop this onto your screen. It's just over 2,000 meters or 2 kilometers, and I'm going to rise, let me just count these, 65 meters. So can you work out how long it will take me? Pause the video and give it a try. Did you work it out? Yes, it's 30 minutes. Or well, if you want to be exact, it's 30 minutes, 30 seconds. Okay, that's 24 minutes to cover the 2 kilometers, and it's an extra 6.5 minutes for the height gain. Now, don't forget, as I said, I'm on Spittler's Edge. Spittler's, interesting thing. I always say that anywhere in England, you can find something interesting. Well, I find it interesting anyway. I'll give you an example. Thousands of people walk in this area, probably tens of thousands every year, and they walk along this ridge, Spittler's Edge. But how many of them know why it's called Spittler's Edge? Obviously, it's an edge because you know, the ground drops away on either side of it. But what is a spittler? I know it's a strange name, and you know, so if you live in this area, you can bore your friends with this. Just like I do. Well, I'll do this to you anyway. I'll bore you. So it's a good question, so thanks for asking. Do you remember from your school days, one of your history lessons may have been about a group called the Knights Hospitaller? Okay, they were a group of Teutonic knights. Teutonicus just means Germanic in Latin, so they were from Germany. Now they came together during the Crusades, and basically they formed what we would call a charity. You know, they decided to look after the poor and run hospitals and generally do good deeds from about the 12th century onwards. They had lands all over Europe, including in this area. Now, there were different leaders of the Knights Hospitaller. There was a Hochmeister, or the Grand Master, who was in overall charge. His deputy was the Grosskomtur, and the treasurer was the Tesler. But the person that was responsible for running the hospitals in an area was called the Spittler, which is from an old German word for healer. And this ridge was the route between some of the Knights Hospitaller's estates in the 14th century. And the ridge is named after the Spittler, who used to ride along this ridge 800 years ago. Waffle. What was I saying? Oh yeah, from here to from 392 to the top of Great End, it'll take 30 minutes 30 seconds. Now, this all sounds very specific and scientific, and it isn't, you know, but as Naismith is the most commonly used formula, we have to ask, is it accurate? No. The reason it's not accurate is that it was never meant to be accurate. You know, in 1892, Naismith called his idea a rule, but the word has changed over the years, and what was a rule then, we now call a rule of thumb, which has absolutely nothing to do, by the way, with beating your wife with a certain size stick. Don't even comment on that. Anyway, a rule of thumb is something which has been gained from experience and practice rather than calculation. So sometimes it's correct and sometimes it isn't. Most of the time it isn't. As I said, Naismith didn't take into account the type of terrain you're walking over. You know, if you go in a deep snow or through bogs or poor visibility or a heavy rucksack, they all change the speed at, you know, that you're going to walk somewhere, and Naismith doesn't take this into account. So even though it's not very accurate, it is brilliant for one thing, and this is the reason that it's used so much. It's very simple and it can be adjusted to your own situation and most terrains. You know, Naismith provides a rough estimate of the time you'll be walking. Now, over the last 130 years, there's been lots of attempts to improve it, and these are known as corrections. Sometimes even the corrections are changed, and the correct changes to the corrections are actually called variations. But don't dig into it too deep, you know, it just gets confusing. So some of the corrections are obviously wrong, but don't forget that Naismith is just a rule of thumb. So basically, it's an estimate, so any changes to it will be equally inaccurate. So let's just, I'll give you a couple of examples of corrections. Let's start with Tranter's correction, which, just my opinion, I think it's based on a wrong assumption. Tranter's is based on how fit you are, and it puts everybody into a number of brackets, 15, 20, 25, 30, 40, 50. And using those numbers, you can calculate the distance over a number of hours. You know, the lower the bracket, the slower you'll walk. The reason that I think Tranter's is wrong is it's based on how fast you walk over 800 meters and rise 300. Now, you know, that's quite a steep slope, and if you can do that for 800 meters, there's nothing to say that you can continue doing that for 8 hours over, you know, a normal walking day. So to base it on how fast you walk a very short distance, Tranter's is, I wouldn't say it's correct. The Atkins correction, that's another one. That changes the speed that people walk over different terrains. As an example, it lowers the walking speed from 5 kilometers an hour to 4 kilometers an hour once you leave a path or a track, you know, you start walking over the hills. The Langmuir correction basically says that you speed up when you're going down easy, you know, quite steep slopes, and that you slow down when you're going up quite steep slopes, you know, so you add 10 minutes, take 10 minutes away in various situations. But, you know, there's lots of different corrections, and Most people don't use them. Most people just use the very, very basic tranters, you know, 5 kilometers, 100 meters, 10 minutes. Now, there are other corrections, and they all try and make Naismiths a little bit more accurate. But the problem is with them is that none of them, you know, none of them are accurate for large numbers of people. The first attempt to try and work out the walking speed for millions of people was in the USA, when they were trying to calculate the new wind chill formula, and they needed to know the distance that lots of people walked. So what they did is they used the cameras on thousands of traffic lights to record the speed that pedestrians crossed the road, because they knew the width of the road. The Ordnance Survey is still doing things like this. At the moment, they're recording the walking speeds of thousands of people who've downloaded the Ordnance Survey Maps app, but only for people who've been given permission. Anyway, back to Naismiths. I would suggest that we all know how fit we are. And if you're a hill runner, then 5 kilometers an hour for 8 hours, no problems. But for everybody else, I would suggest use Naismiths as a minimum. So maybe add 25% if you're quite fit and it's just a short walk, or 50% if you're not so fit and you may be walking over difficult terrain or micro navigating or lack of visibility. But nothing is going to ever be able to tell exactly how fast you're going to walk. But Naismiths does give you a good idea. Now, as I said, Naismiths has proved to be the best option for at least 130 years, as it's very, very simple, you know, and you can amend it for anything that you want. So next time you're out, give it a try and see if it works. Don't forget, 12 minutes a kilometre and add 10 minutes for each 100 metre rise. On all my courses and private lessons, I use the Atkins correction just because I think it's so simple. You know, it's basically Naismiths goes on 5 kilometers an hour, but when you're up in the hills, the Atkins goes on 4 kilometers an hour. So if you're walking for half an hour, you're doing 2 kilometers, quarter of an hour, 1 kilometer. So every 100 meters takes you a minute and a half. And then you just add 1 minute for every 10 meters that you rise. And that's what makes it so simple. You know, if you want to walk for 300 meters, you just times 3 by 1.5. So 300 meters will take you 4.5 minutes. 500 meters will take you 7.5 minutes. And then you just add 1 minute for each, you know, each minute. Then you add 1 minute for each 10 minutes of rise. So that's it. That's really all you need to know about Naismith's rule. And I'm sorry to rabbit on, but I think it's going to start raining very, very quickly. As you can see, the weather is not too good today, but it's England and it's coming up to summer. This is what we get. So I'm just going to sit here for a little bit longer and have a flask and a bite to eat. Oh, by the way, we haven't got sandwiches today. Just thought I'd tell you what we have today. We don't have sandwiches, we have bagels. Oh, come on, look at this. We have bagels, cream cheese, smoked salmon, crushed capers, and some very thinly sliced spring onions. I mean, even if it rains, life is still good. Thanks for watching. Oh, good.